Clone Captain Rex is one of the most beloved clone troopers of the entire Star Wars franchise. Despite never being featured in an official saga movie, he has captivated audiences with his impressive feats. So today, we are going to be looking into the history of Captain Rex and his achievements in the galaxy. CT-7567, nicknamed Rex, was a veteran clone trooper captain and leader of Torrent Company of the infamous 501st Legion. He served directly under General Anakin Skywalker and Ahsoka Tano throughout the Clone Wars. Other notable accomplices to Rex are Commander Cody and Obi-Wan Kenobi, whom Anakin and Rex most often fought alongside. We first see Rex in the Battle of Christophsis, notoriously wielding two DC-17 blaster pistols that he ultimately grows very fond of. On Christophsis, the Republic forces are in deep peril. The battle droids are slowly closing in on their base, and what's worse is there is a spy amongst the clone ranks. Rex and Cody are tasked with weeding out the turncoat and stopping his sabotage. After following a trail of successful leads, Rex and Cody find out the spy is their brother Slick. After stopping the sabotage of the Republic's heavy cannons, Rex joins General Kenobi on the front lines of the battle. They manage to stop the droids dead in their tracks and win victory over the Separatist forces. The Battle of Christophsis is just the beginning of the crazy adventures that Rex and his friends go on. Just after leaving the planet, Rex and the 501st are ordered to Teth to rescue Jabba the Hutt's son. This is portrayed in the animated Star Wars movie, The Clone Wars. Directly after the Battle of Teth, Rex and Cody are sent to inspect the Republic base at the Rishi Moon. Little did they know that their inspection could end up being one of the most important assignments of these two leaders' careers. The Rishi outpost was charged with monitoring Kamino communications in order to protect the planet. If this outpost were to fall, then Kamino would be vulnerable to attack. When Rex and Cody went to inspect the outpost, it had been taken over by Separatist commando droids. Rex, Cody, and members of the Domino Squad successfully destroyed the base in order to warn the Republic of the Separatist attack, subsequently saving the Kamino cloning facility in the process. Rex engages in many more key battles for the Republic in the Clone Wars after this, some of the more notable ones being the Battle of Umbara, Fallujah, and the Second Battle of Geonosis. However, Rex's career did not end at Order 66. He had managed to take out his inhibitor chip and thus avoided joining the Empire. After Order 66, Commander Wolf and Rex and Gregor lived together in a modified ATTE on the desert planet of Seelos. Then, one day, they are visited by a small rebel group. Reluctantly at first, Rex and his comrades join the rebellion, and later participate in many more missions. Overall, Rex is one of the most important members of Star Wars history. His long-lived loyalty to good and his hardships shape him up to be a very competent leader and ally. The Star Wars universe would be a very different place without this clone. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Let me know if you want me to do some more of these Star Wars, like, profiles, almost. I could certainly do some more, and they don't just have to be clone commanders, although they could. So yeah guys, thanks so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. Comment, rate, and subscribe if you did, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace!